So, two nights ago, I just finished reading Sadie, by Courtney Summers. It's a book that I've heard about because of being on BookTube in the past. I found it back in about April. So, it's been a few months now, and I've been like addicted to it and watching BookTube like crazy. And I don't know what is so interesting about watching people just sit and talk about books they've read or want to read or whatever, but I don't know. I just find it interesting, and there's some really great personalities out there. So a few people have talked about Sadie, so I picked this one up from the library and I read it in like 3 days. I read a lot of books in a year, about 45 to 50 books in a year, but these BookTubers are reading like 150 books a year. They'll read like 12, 14 books in a month, and I'm lucky if I finish four books in a month. But it has been pushing me to want to read more and to spend more time reading. So I'm like, I just have to get off of BookTube and actually reading more. But so I picked up Sadie and I read it. I started it October 19th and finished it the 22nd. So it's 308 pages long. So that was a really fast read. But for me, like, it's a decent sized book. So I read it pretty quickly. I'll just tell you really quick. It's about this girl named Sadie, who is her sister has been killed, so she's out kind of looking for revenge. The cops didn't really do a great job of trying to solve the murder, and she goes missing. Like, she doesn't tell anyone that she's going to search for who she believes killed her sister. And so someone else is kind of like a, she's like a grandmother to them. And she calls up this like radio station personality and says, you know, my granddaughter's missing. No one's doing a good job looking for her. The cops are incompetent, all this stuff. And so it's told, you get the perspective of Sadie, but you also get the person, it's written like a podcast. And they, this guy who's doing the podcast is like searching and he's interviewing people and trying to follow Sadie's trail. So there's a little bit of timeline differences as well. But it's like a podcast and it's called The Girls. And then you see like them talking. So I imagine this would be a really good audiobook to listen to, but I couldn't find it. But yeah, it was really, really interesting. There are some trigger warnings of death or murder. It deals with abuse and sexual assault, especially to children. And the main character, Sadie, has a stutter, which isn't really a trigger warning, but so, and just talking about her past and her abuse and things that her and her sister have gone through. Deals with a parent having alcohol and drug addiction as well. So there are a few trigger warnings, and it was a pretty intense book, but I really enjoyed it. So if those things interest you, it is young adult read, so I don't really know what that means. Like, I know what young adult is, but so she's 19 and her sister was 13 when she was murdered. So, but it is written for teenagers or young adults, so it's not necessarily a hard read that way, but it does deal with some really heavy topics and I really enjoyed it. I think I gave it like 4 stars. I don't normally give stars or ratings on books. I just did it. I just started actively using Goodreads and watching BookTube and stuff like that, so they all give their ratings. But anyways, that's all I wanted to say about Sadie, and now I gotta go pick up my son and do some running around downtown. So thanks for listening to this book review.